Hey, you're just in time to see another Todd's Tips.
Oh, God, that's disgusting.
You know, someone's mind is in the gutter. I said Todd's Tips. Tips.
Disgusting.
But first, my coffee cup of the day. It's the Squat and Gobble restaurant in South Carolina. One of the regulars at Daddy Pop's restaurants bought me this and brought it back when he came back. He knows I love mugs, but today we are going to show you how to map every ROWE CD jukebox ever made. Now, there aren't a whole lot of them. I think there's maybe 15 years of them. And we actually put it all on paper, and I'm going to have this at the end of the film that you can see and then freeze and then copy down. But there are two different mapping processes. One is if you change all the CDs at once and you want to put them all in, or number two, if you're putting one CD box at the same time. What is this?
It's a mopped jukebox.
Do you see what I put up with?
Kurt!
Where is Kurt? Right.
First of all, you lift the jukebox up. Now, I want to point something out. Right here, there used to be three points. And the jukebox is designed that these help hold the box up, but they never did, they never will. It's the design of the jukebox. ROWE sold you, when they sold you the jukebox, they sold you one of these clips to hold it up. What happened is one of the clips broke, and that point went down and dug right into my skull.
Were you wearing your helmet?
Best day ever!
Anyway, that will never happen again to any of my customers because I have removed those. Because these are going into homes, they don't have to be locked. This way you don't looking for a key and you lost the key and golly gee, you just lower the lid, it'll stay down flat. Now, mapping a jukebox. To make this easier, I'm going to remove the player in the back right here. Now, this is here. See how this sits in here and rides in there like that? Very simple operation. This actually lifts out and unplugs. Now you can see it there. Boy, that was noisy. Okay, let's put that over here. The perfect workbench, the trash can. Now this jukebox, you'll notice, has this lovely color arrangement here. And then two light bulbs, sign bulbs that light up.
Bubs.
And then there's, Wallace, I apologize. Bubs. Another fluorescent light up here, okay. Now, if you follow our instructions, we are just going to put in one CD. Very simple. Open lid. Slide normal service switch to service. Now, over here on the side, every ROWE jukebox on planet Earth has the same system. Service. Now, right behind it, you're always going to see a power switch on-off. When you flip that, it turns the computer off. So there's zero power getting to the machine. However, the fluorescent lights stay on. But we don't want to turn that off. We're going to leave that in the on position. Now, the next part is to look at the display. Now, I already locked this in to show you what to do. Most people open up the lid just enough. They slide the switch and they hold the lid up and then they close the lid back down. But you can't close it all the way. Because if you do, it's going to push that switch back into normal. Now let's look here. Next part. The display reads, errors exist. It will always, always, always read that. You will never get it not to read that. So don't worry about it. Press popular and reset at the same time. Okay? Display reads service mode. Easy so far. Press 3. Display says initialize. Press 1 on keypad. Now, this is the difference between these two. If you press 0, it'll initialize the whole box. But we only want to do 1. So we're going to hit 1. Okay, now, program initialization. What that means is what CD do you want to do? Now, all of our CDs start with the letter, the numbers 00, 01, 02, they go up to 99. It's always two digits because the jukebox holds 100 records and you can't put number 100 because that's three digits. So they do an 00. So watch, I'm going to hit 00. Okay? Then I press popular. Did you see that flash? The flash means the computer understood it. And now it's ready for another one. But we're not going to do another one. Now, we are going to put the clip back in and put our CD in 00. Now, you may say to me, what's the reason to map one at a time? If you wanted to make a change in your selections and you didn't want to deal with all of them, because it takes a while to initialize. But you may say, what's initialization? That's where the jukebox learns all the songs on the record. Okay, it has to know what's on there. That means if some drunken dummy comes up to it and punches in 0099, because there can't be 99 tracks on one, the jukebox won't accept it. If it did, the imbecile would lose his money and it'd be going, that's what he would say.
I'm not making fun of your nephew, he's standing right there.
Jonathan, have you ever done that when you were in a drunken rage?
Nope.
Okay. Now, we come down here. Now, you see the button that says cancel? Well, in this case, it becomes scan. So the button is actually scan. The label faces this way, and you simply slide it in to the record slot. That's 00 here and there. You want to make sure you get it right. You can so easily do that. Now, once all the CDs are in it, you're not going to do it. Nobody's going to be that dumb. Okay. I heard that. Okay. We're ready. Now, by the way, your manual has all that information in it. It's conveniently located in a pouch. Roe did a really nice job with this. Okay. Now, also, inside, just so you know, your bass treble controls are in there. You can actually make adjustments. You can add speakers. These jukeboxes are so versatile. You can put speakers out by the swimming pool, all kinds of different places. Now, I'm going to show you how to put the strips in. You take the strip out of your CD holder and you put that in first. Okay, now some people put the whole booklet in, other people just tear off the front page of the booklet and then put the rest of it into it. And then you put your title strip in. Ah, look, isn't that clever? Now it blanks the hole right there. Isn't that a nice idea? So that covers your hole there. Now, these are available online, but you can also make copies on sheets that will go into your computer. So you can very easily get around these things. Okay, do that now. Now we got that done, see? Now, I know some people that take a piece of clear tape and put it here, just a little piece that holds the two together, because we tend to see when the page is flipped, this slides out. Okay, so that's another option, another little trick. That you can try to keep them in nice and tight. Okay, now we take this and we put it back in. You feed this in first here. Up there, I mean, up there on this side. Boy, am I that bad, Jonathan? Gosh.
Yep. Can I answer that?
Can I answer that?
Don't forget the plug.
Yes, the plug goes up. These slip up like so. Good. And we put the plug in. Where is Mr. Plug? Good. Ta-da. Now, here's the best part. We're done. Because you'll notice that as soon as we close the lid, the electronics take over. And now the machine is spinning. I'm going to take a little peek because we can open it up because now it's in regular mode, see? It's dropped the record on top of the player, and now it's initializing it. See, it initializes it right away. And now the jukebox knows all the smash hits I've programmed into it, and then I can play them. So it's OO. By the way, that's not the Irish drinking songs. It's not the CD I put in there. Although, Jonathan, that could be your CD.
I like it.
You know what? We'll have to give that to him. And then we'll hit 01. And then instantly, the machine will find the CD, drop it down, spin the player like so, and the needle will drop down on the record. Actually, it won't. Happens to be one of the greatest songs ever written. God, that was written 40 years ago? Ooh. And it was actually a good movie by Whoopi that made a movie with it. You're done. Now, that takes seconds, doesn't it? I'm going to show you that page now. Now, do you see this page? What you can do is download the page, print it, freeze the video, and write it down. No, I'm not emailing it to you. Sorry. Good. We're done with the page. It's time for another sip of coffee from the Squat and Gobble. Yeah. And it's time to do another video. Look what Steven's working on. The Road King. Kids go nuts for that game. Okay. And you! Just sitting around. Okay, let me get you. Oh. There we go. Got him nice and red, yeah. He lets me do it because I pay him.
You know where his hands were like 5 minutes ago, right?
Uh-huh. We'll see you later. Good night. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here!